over very quickly. Oh, wow. You just take cover whenever Ngalani swings that big, big leg of his.
Ngalani is about as wide as I am tall. He looks massive, like a superhero, the Panther.
And he does a lot of cardio. I mean, you can see, I guess, but I saw him on the treadmill for a long, long time yesterday. This was the day before the fight.
You can see that Bebezao does not want any part of the stand-up game with Ngalani, but this is a bad spot for him to be in. Bebezao has side control, but he's doing the right thing. He's pushing away, creating a little bit of space.
The strength to lift this man up like that.
He basically bench-pressed him into half guard.
Oh, wow. And then got to his feet. That was a tremendous feat of strength. And a big right hand.
Big.
And he's unloading now. And Machado's in big trouble. He has to go for the legs to try and get some respite, but it's not coming because Ngalani tremendous effort from Machado to bring him down.
Nice single leg trip there. Machado knew he got hurt.
Yuji Shimada making sure that Galani's elbow doesn't make contact with the back of the head. Very important. That's why he stopped the action for a while there.
Yeah, he did exactly the principles behind BJJ. He weathered the big strikes, got this fight back down to the ground where he negates a lot of that power, those strikes that Ngalani has. Let's see if Ngalani can do another one of those bench press escapes again as he tries to get out of there. He does not want to spend too much time on the ground with a black belt, the capability of Machado. He's kind of going the wrong way. Now he's going the right way. Now he's stripping away from the side, but he's got to create more space. But that, all those big muscles, they just suck up so much oxygen. You know, they eat so much energy up. But he believes that he's like, oh, I'm a bodybuilder. That's true. He's a championship level bodybuilder. But he doesn't believe. Now he's got an impossible arm triangle by Machado.
He's got tight around the throat, but he swivels around within it. Very nicely done.
Good job by Ngalani to avoid that arm triangle. Now he's giving up the back, though. He doesn't want it to go this way. Machado's got that arm there on the arm. He's trying to release that. He's going to drop some bombs first.
Bench press this man from this position. This is trouble.
Now he gets flattened out. Uses those hips to kind of spread him out. Now comes some big strikes. Ngalani's got to move. He can't stand there. Yuji Shimada's not going to take it.
Got to be careful of the back of the head.
It's like that mohawk, Steve. It's just that. Imagine that missile mohawk. You can't come anywhere near it.
If you make contact with the ear, it's a legal blow.
You have to intelligently defend yourself. You can't just stay there with your hand protect.
Just cover up. He's taking quite a lot of punishment. It doesn't seem overly bothered by it, but this is a heavyweight, and a big heavyweight who's landing the blows.
He's got to move, Steve. He's got to move. He's got to create a scramble. He can't just sit there. Now he's in the mouth. Too bad. Here comes the rain.
Coming up well, though, Ngalani. The elbows have to go between the arms in order to land. A few in at the side there, just to bury it. Ngalani's in trouble here.
He's got to forget about protecting his face and start pushing off on those legs. He can't stay there and just cover it up.
Got to lift those hips and do something about it because he is a sitting duck at the moment with 90 seconds of this first round still to go. The punches come hammering down from the Brazilian.
Hey, but they're not making contact. He's completely defending and covering up all these shots.
He is covering up well.
A little bit of the hooks on the side are getting through and landing there. He's giving him, there it is, the
arm. The armbar attempt, but that's a strong arm. I'm not sure he'll be able to pull that one all the way to full extension.
He's trying to get it out, but I don't think he's in trouble. I think the elbow's past the groin, so he's not. He's just cranking on the wrist there.
That's a big voice. To work immediately above us here at cage side.
How much energy are these two expending? You know, Machado thought he probably had to finish and just let everything go with those hammer fists.
Big blows.
Ngalani's doing the same thing.
25 seconds left, bitch. It's been an exhausting first 5 minutes for these two.
Back and forth. Bebezao gets back on top. Machado gets a knee to the head.
And now
I'm surprised. surprised it's gone this far. Oh, big takedown attempt.
It's gonna go into a second round. And not many people thought that. A blistering first 5 minutes.
Look at this takedown attempt. Once he got the leg, he was able to suck that leg in, secure the takedown, and he just never let go. And he just used it very nicely, was able to get on top, use a lot of the ground and pound. Here's Ngalani's answer to that. He was letting go a lot of strikes, but again, Machado was able to suck that leg in, weather the storm, and get a dominant position. This is where most of the fight took place, but Ngalani wasn't hurt by any of these. There's a submission attempt, but you can see that his arm is in danger. Machado was in control of more of the fight, you know, and but Ngalani was back and forth, very close first round.
I'm telling you, Mitch, they are going to turn away thousands at the door tonight. This is the hottest ticket in town, the biggest one championship event. It's Conquest of Champions.
Sikini is able to keep his distance with that rear leg push kick, and his own gets inside the pocket, starts letting the hands go a little bit.
Big looping punches there from Sikini. And he's starting to gas the big fella, hands around the waist, but I'm not sure if Machado's striking can really capitalize on it. Shoots him for a single here, Sikini tries for a driving takedown. To no avail on that occasion, goes to a double leg now, does the big man. Looping right hook there from Sikini, and Shrek breaks off.
Good job by Machado to avoid that bum rush of a takedown. Utilize the underhooks, pick Sikini up, and push him off.
Machado just staying out of range of the hands of Sikini. Overhand right there. Is this when that lactic acid starts to build up and slow you down and get inside the muscles, make you make the arms heavy, the legs heavy?
If you do something you're unused, if you're not used to it, and striking, they both, nice right hand there, landed by Machado. It's definitely gonna slow you down, but if this is what they're doing, if they're grappling, if they're clinching, oh, Machado, this is opening.
Sikini on his back now, here comes the ground and pound from Machado. The full mount from the Brazilian, and Sikini with a whole world above it now. Machado timing his shots, picking his opening. Sikini gives his back, nowhere to go. Olivia Cost says no more. Machado pounds him out.
Look at this, big ground and pound landed. Sikini gave up the arm bar right there. Bebezao said none of that, put you onto your belly, and I'm gonna let these hammers fly.
Alexandre Machado.
Carrying it around full intensity for 15 minutes is very, very tough. Ngalani is feeling the heat.
I don't know if he's gonna have the juice to stop this takedown. Here he is clearly holding the cage to avoid the takedown.
He's gone, he's exhausted, Ngalani. Yeah, it's over, it's over. Alexandre Machado has just put himself in pole position for that one. But these big, big guys can't really be expected.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.